hold kjeft da! Er folk fra noen kulturer mer hissige og blir lettere fornærmet enn andre? Nå skal jeg møte en psykolog som heter Richard Nisbett, som gjorde et veldig kult eksperiment for å finne ut akkurat det.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Good to meet you.
How old are you?
Hi. Good to see you.
It's an honor to be here. Have there been any other Norwegian documentary teams there?
Not this week.
Not this week.
Richard Nisbett født og oppvokst I sørstatene, I El Paso I Texas.
At age 17, I went away to college in what to me was a foreign country, Boston, Massachusetts.
For sørstatsgutten Nisbett var det mange ting som føltes fremmed I nordstatene.
And one of them was that middle-class people don't kill each other in Massachusetts. And they did, where I came from.
I deler av sørstatene det 4 ganger så mange drap per 100 000 innbyggere sammenlignet med nordstatene. Og det særlig én type drap som forekommer oftere.
It was found that the homicides that were elevated were those where there was plausibly an insult. A romantic triangle, or an argument in a bar, or something.
Men hvorfor var det så mange drap utløst av fornærmelser akkurat I sørstatene? Nisbett og hans kolleger begynte å gjøre store spørreundersøkelser I ulike deler av USA om holdninger til vold, og de fant 3 ting som skilte sørstats fra nordstatsamerikanerne.
First of all, the appropriateness of violence in response to an insult. Secondly, the appropriateness of violence if there's been some kind of threat to home or family. And third, violence in the socialization of children.
Sørstatsamerikanerne lærer nemlig sine barn andre holdninger til vold enn nordstatsforeldre.
If a kid comes in and tells his parents that some other kid is beating him up or threatened to beat him up. I mean, the northern parent, the civilized northern parent, would be like, you know, you should reason with him. You should try and figure out what it is that, why he's behaving this way. And, you know, or you tell the teacher. The southern reaction would be, beat that kid up or you're in trouble.
Nøkkelen til å forstå disse forskjellene fikk Nisbett fra en kollega som hadde studert kulturer I Midtøsten.
And he says, oh yes, that's culture of honor.
Det altså ikke bare I Midtøsten man har æreskulturer. Men det sånn at folk fra æreskulturer faktisk mer hissige? For å teste ut dette gjorde Nisbett et eksperiment som blitt berømt som det såkalte drittsekk-eksperimentet.
We had southern and northern U.S. subjects who were at the University of Michigan come into the laboratory for a study on thinking. As soon as they get to the laboratory, they fill out a questionnaire. The experimenter says, please take your questionnaire down to the end of the hall and leave it on the table at the end. And there's a guy standing at one of the file cabinets with the drawer out, and he's blocking the participant's way to the table. Participant turns around, and he's going to have to get past this guy at the file cabinets again. So the guy slams the cabinet door shut, pushes into the shoulder of the participant and says, asshole. Now the question is, how do people react to this? Northern subjects sort of give a little startle and sort of laugh. I mean, sort of, what's your problem? The southern subjects flush.
Asshole. Hey!
I mean, they get obviously angry.
Nisbett tok også spyttprøver for rent kjemisk å måle hvor sinte de egentlig hadde blitt.
When we measure subsequently their cortisone level, which indicates their stress level, that's been increased. It's been a stress for the southerners. It's not a stress for the northerners, so far as their cortisol level is concerned. And testosterone level increases for the southerners. So they're ready for a fight. It doesn't increase for the northerners.
Nisbett utførte flere lignende eksperimenter, og alle viste det samme. Folk fra sørstatene mer hissige enn folk fra nordstatene. Men ikke dette en uheldig type forskning som stempler én gruppe som voldelige hissigpropper?
When I first started doing this research and talking about it in public, I was afraid that I would offend southerners. No, the only people I offend is northern liberals. Who take, you know, who out of a sense of political correctness, they would sometimes say at the end of my talks, this is terrible the way you're talking about these southern people. making them look bad. And I said, but no Southerner ever.
They're proud of it.
They're proud of it, and they can't believe that Northerners are such wimps.
Mens folk I Nordstatene oppfatter deres hissighet som noe litt barnslig.
Right, right, exactly. Immature, lacking in self-control, poor sense of balance.
Det var dette litt umoden og barnslige ved æreskulturer som var utgangspunktet for de sketsjene om respekt vi hadde I Team Antonsen.
Se på meg, Jølstrud. Det vis meg respekt, Jølstrud.
Vis han respekt.
Vis meg respekt.
Vis han respekt, da.
Jølstrud.
En ting hvordan nordmenn opplever folk fra æreskulturer. Men jeg lurer på, hvorfor de så hissige? Hvorfor oppstår sånne kulturer?
There's an expression in North Carolina, which is part of the South, the U.S. Every man a sheriff on his own hearth. So that means you have to take care of your own home. You have to be the law in your own home to protect yourself, because nobody's going to be around to protect you. Your only protection is yourself.
Well, let's go get them.
Ifølge Nisbet oppstår æreskulturer I samfunn hvor man ikke har politi og rettsstat, og ikke minst I samfunn som har dyr på beite.
It's because if you keep animals for a living, somebody can take away your entire livelihood in an instance. They can just take all of your animals. And the way you make sure that nobody's going to do that to you is by making it clear that you're a tough guy and you won't tolerate any kind of nonsense. No jokes at my expense, no insult, nothing, or I'll strike you down. To be willing to spring into violence unpredictably is an advantage in a culture of honor. I mean, don't mess with him. You never know what he's going to do.
Villigheten til å slå tilbake har altså en avskrekkende funksjon. Ulempen at dette ofte fører til hevnspiraler.
Prinsippet hevn en ganske vanlig og veldig dypt forankret I den somaliske kulturen, særlig den gamle somaliske kulturen, hvor hvis en familiemedlem, gjerne en far, blir drept, så skal sønnen hevne seg for ham.
I moderne samfunn sørger stat og politi for at det ikke lenger har noen hensikt å slå tilbake.
You just curtail your own anger. I mean, and if someone takes some kind of action against you or some kind of threat against you, your first thought is going for the law.